With execution domain specification, you can define how a component runs. For instance, a component can be run in a discrete manner, or for signal processing applications, it can be run in dataflow mode, which has automatic multi-core simulation for computationally intensive or multi-rate systems. Setting your components to run in the correct execution domain will mean the component will run in the fastest and most efficient manner, as well as generate the most efficient code. This model is a simple model of a controller and plant. To specify a subsystem's execution domain, you can open the property inspector or open the sample time legend. Using the sample time legend, we can see that the plant is continuous, the controller is hybrid, and that the controller outputs a discrete rate of 40 milliseconds. If we go into the controller, we see that the input and gain block are continuous, while the PID controller block and output are discrete. And that is why the subsystem is hybrid. We could either worry about setting sample times and thus influence how they're executed at the block level, or we can do it at the subsystem level. To do it at the subsystem level, we use the badge in the bottom left corner, which currently shows that the execution domain is not discrete. We click on that to open the Property Inspector's Execution tab. If you want to specify this as discrete, you can use the checkbox in pull down to specify it as discrete. If it's a very complicated model, you want Simulink to help you set the execution domain, so you choose Deduce from Contents. Then, if you update the model, you see that Simulink would set the subsystem to discrete. In this case, though, you would want to lock down this execution domain to be discrete, and that would prevent you or others from accidentally introducing a block into this model that is outside the specified execution domain, which in this case was discrete, and therefore would cause execution to be incorrect if allowed. That is why dragging a continuous block into a discrete subsystem is an error. With execution domain specification, you can quickly lock down the execution type of a component, making the component more efficient both in simulation by avoiding unnecessary solver hits and avoid generating unnecessary code for unwanted execution domain switches as well.